So, priya vidyarthigale, ivattu naavu prathama PUC organic chapters na nodana. Actually, first PUC nalli erada organic chapters ide. Some basic principles and techniques in organic chemistry anta vandu, hydrocarbons anta innondu. So, ivu first naavu basic principles and techniques in organic chemistry nodadadre, idralli balastu points galu bartave. So, IUPAC nomenclature of organic, introduction to organic compound, the first again you already know it. Adar mele organic compounds galige nomenclature bagge nodadadre, IUPAC matte common system anta eradu baruthe. Common system is based on the source, IUPAC system is based on the structure, adralli prefix, word root, suffix. So, yavyadakke enen baribeku adella sikkapatte rules ide. So, ಅದನ್ನೆಲ್ಲ ಫಾಲೋ ಮಾಡಿ ನಾವು ಲಾಂಗೆಸ್ಟ್ ಚೈನ್ ರೂಲ್ ಆಗಿರ್ಬೋದು, ಲೋಯೆಸ್ಟ್ ಸಮ್ ರೂಲ್ ಆಗಿರ್ಬೋದು, ಅರೇಂಜ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಪ್ರಿಫಿಕ್ಸಸ್ ಆಗಿರ್ಬೋದು, ಆಮೇಲೆ ಪ್ರೆಸೆನ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಮೋರ್ ದೆನ್ ಒನ್ ಫಂಕ್ಷನಲ್ ಗ್ರೂಪ್ ಆಗಿರ್ಬೋದು, ಈ ರೂಲ್ಸ್ಗಳನ್ನೆಲ್ಲ ಫಾಲೋ ಮಾಡಿಕೊಂಡು ನಾವು IUPAC ನೇಮ್ಸ್ನ ಕೊಡ್ತಾ ಹೋಗ್ತೀವಿ. ಅದಾದಮೇಲೆ ರಿಯಾಕ್ಷನ್ ಇಂಟರ್ಮೀಡಿಯೇಟ್ಸ್ ಬರುತ್ತೆ, ಅದರಲ್ಲಿ ಹೋಮೋಲಿಸಿಸ್ಸು, ಹೆಟ್ರೋಲಿಸಿಸ್ಸು. ಸೊ ಹೋಮೋಲಿಸಿಸ್ ಅಂದರೆ ಸಿಮಿಟ್ರಿಕಲ್ ಕ್ಲೀವೇಜ್ ಆಫ್ ಎ ಬಾಂಡ್, ಇಟ್ ಲೀಡ್ಸ್ ಟು ಫಾರ್ಮ್ ಎ ಫ್ರೀ ರ್ಯಾಡಿಕಲ್ಸ್. Whereas ಹೆಟ್ರೋಲಿಸಿಸ್ ಈಸ್ ಎ ಅನ್ಸಿಮಿಟ್ರಿಕಲ್ ಕ್ಲೀವೇಜ್ ಆಫ್ ಎ ಬಾಂಡ್, ವಿಟ್ ಲೀಡ್ಸ್ ಟು ಫಾರ್ಮ್ ಎ ಕ್ಯಾಟಯಾನ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಆನಯಾನ್. The cation formed during electrolysis is nothing but electrophile. The anion, negative charged species formed due to heterolysis is nothing but nucleophile. So after that we have carbon free radical, carbon carrying a free radical due to homolysis. Carbon free radical will be formed and its hybridization is sp2. Its order of stability will be benzyl free radical. Benzyl free radical is nothing but benzene ring carrying a carbon free radical. This is nothing but benzyl free radical. So because of presence of alternative pi bonds here, so this benzyl free radical is more stable because of resonation structure. So after that, tertiary carbon free radical is more stable, then secondary, then primary. So this is the order of stability of carbon free radicals. Similarly, if you take carbocation, carbon carrying positive charge, so this carbocation is obtained due to heterolysis, unsymmetrical cleavage of a bond. So here carbon completely loses one bond, forming a C+. Its hybridization is sp2, and its order of stability will be benzyl, then tertiary, then secondary, then primary. Similarly, we have one more called carbanion, carbon carrying negative charge, and this is obtained by heterolysis of a bond, and here that bonding electrons are completely gained by the carbon, forming C-. So here its hybridization is sp3. Why its hybridization is sp3? Because here carbon does not loses any electron, whereas in case of homolysis and due to the formation of carbocation by heterolysis, here carbon loses electron undergo sp2 hybridization, but here carbon gains electron. Whatever the electrons are there in the carbon remains same. So that's why here the hybridization of carbon is sp3. So order of stability will be, so primary is more stable than secondary, secondary is more stable than tertiary. So students, using these stability, order of stability of carbon, carbocation, carbon free radical and carbon ion, so we have so many CET bits to solve here. These are also helps to judge some of the named reactions in the second year PUC concepts. So very important order of stabilities. So kindly go through with these orders. And next is isomerism, one of the separate topic of this chapter, that is isomerism. Generally organic compounds shows isomerism because these organic compounds are containing covalent bonds, and these covalent bonds are directional. So yava bonds alli directional property idiyo aa bonds na en madutave isomerisms torusute, having same molecular formula but differ in the structure or differ in the arrangement or differ in the physical or chemical properties is nothing but isomerism. So these isomerism are broadly classified into two types. One is structural isomerism, another one is stereoisomerism. In case of structural isomerism, there is a difference in the structure, so it is again classified into chain isomerism, position isomerism, functional isomerism, metamerism, tautomerism. So chain isomerism, we know that same molecular formula but differ in the number of carbon atoms in the main chain. So position isomerism, also we know that same molecular formula but differ in the position of the substituent or functional group. Bute 1-ene, bute 2-ene is nothing but position isomerism. So similarly butanol and butane 2-ol, so are also nothing but positional isomerism. So functional isomerism having same molecular formula but differ in the functional group. So generally we have four important functional isomers are there. So alcohols are the functional isomers of ether. Similarly ethers are the functional isomers of alcohol. So aldehydes are the functional isomers of ketones. And carboxylic acids are the functional isomers of esters. Cyanides are the functional isomers of isocyanides. Nitrites are the functional isomers of nitro groups. So we have various functional isomers will be there. After that we have metamerism. So it is one of the important isomerism shown by the organic compounds, that is metamerism. So if any organic compound containing non-chain terminating functional group, non-chain terminating, that means functional group is present in the middle of the carbon atom, where carbon atoms are more than four in the main chain, can show metamerism. Generally ketone group, ether group, ester group, so they can show metamerism. So where, and to show metamerism, one more condition is that organic compound contains at least a minimum four or more than four carbon atoms in the main chain. So next is tautomerism. So it is nothing but rearrangement. Conversion of enol into keto form is nothing but tautomerism. Of course, one more structural isomerism will be there, that is sixth one, called ring chain isomerism. So that is, that will appears very rarely in the organic compound. So after that structural isomerism, we have stereoisomerism, very important for your competitive examination. Stereoisomerism means there is a differ in the spatial arrangement. So that spatial arrangement can be differ by rotating the carbon-carbon bond, that is what conformational isomers. So we have so many conformational isomers to represent that conformational isomerism. We have Sawhorse method, Newman projection formulas like that. So the stereoisomerism are classified into two types, geometrical and optical. So geometrical isomerism means here carbon-carbon rotation is completely restricted. There is no possibility of rotating carbon-carbon bond. So because here geometrical isomerisms can be shown by an organic compound which containing carbon-carbon double bond. At least one carbon-carbon double bond should be there in the organic compound. And these double bonded carbon atoms are attached to different groups. So why it has to attach it to different group? Because if different groups are there, then asymmetry is possible in the molecule. So any molecule having asymmetry, so we can write one more structure there. So that's why they can show isomerism. So that's why the conditions to show geometrical isomerism is molecules should contain at least one double bond, and these double bonded carbon atoms are attached to the different groups. And we can write two different isomerisms here. One is cis form, another one is trans form. In the cis form, double bonded carbon atoms attached to similar groups, whereas in the trans forms, double bonded carbon atoms are attached on the opposite sides. So that is a different thing we will discuss one more time in the hydrocarbon chapter. So next is optical isomerism. In optical isomerism, we have two isomerisms, dextro and levo. In case of dextro isomerism, to show this optical isomerism, any molecule should be optically active in nature. So what is that optical active? So organic compound should contain a chiral carbon, that is carbon with four different groups, and that chiral carbon having capacity to rotate a plane polarized light towards right side or left side. If it rotates towards right side, called dextro. If it rotates towards left side, called levo. So and this is what some points regarding the isomerism. And next we have types of organic reaction. So there are four different types of organic reactions will be there: substitution, addition, elimination, rearrangement. So in case of substitution, again we have three types: free radical substitution, electrophilic substitution, nucleophilic substitution. Addition also free radical addition, electrophilic addition, nucleophilic addition. So elimination reactions already we discussed so many times: dehydrohalogenation, dehydration, dehydrogenation. So these are the few examples of elimination. So removal of HIX, H2O, H2, O2, all these are CO2, decarboxylation, all these are examples for elimination. And for example, if you take dehydrogenation or dehydrohalogenation, it is a beta elimination where hydrogen is removed from the beta carbon, hence we call it as a beta elimination. So to do elimination reaction, so we are going to take a specific reagent that is alcoholic KOH in nature. So after that we have a rearrangement reaction. I told you enol to keto form, conversion of enol to keto and keto to enol form is nothing but a rearrangement reaction. That is a position of hydrogen is shifted from one place to another place within the molecule itself. So finally we have electronic effects in the organic compound. Why electronic effects are taking place in the organic compound? Because to get a stability. To get a stability, so electronic displacement has to take place in a covalent bond that is either sigma or in the pi. So here we have four different effects are there: inductive effect, electromeric effect, mesomeric effect, hyperconjugation. So similarly, after that we have analysis part, one more important point of this chapter called qualitative analysis and quantitative analysis. In case of qualitative analysis, we are going to identify what are the elements present in the given organic compound, that is identification of carbon and hydrogen by copper oxide method, whereas nitrogen, halogen and sulfur by Lesine's test and phosphorus identification test. So the ammonium phosphomolybdate reagent na balaskondu phosphorus irodanna kandidkoltivi. So these are the qualitative, that is identify the organic compound. So next is quantitative analysis. Here we are going to estimate the percentage of element present in the given organic compound, that is estimation of carbon and hydrogen by Liebig's method, estimation of halogen by Sulfur-Carius method, estimation of nitrogen by Dumas method, Jeldahl's method. So like that we have so many points here. So students, this chapter is very important for your competitive examinations. So kindly go through with all the points with the given time. I utilize so many points here. So guys, apart from these points, we have variety. So many points are there. So kindly follow all the points. Basic strength of students, we will solve some questions now. First question is basic strength of. So he given three carbon ions, carbon carrying negative charge, CH3 CH2 minus, CH2 double bond CH minus, CH triple bond C minus. You just see this is a single bond, carbon-carbon single bond, alkane, alkene, alkynes. So ee moorudu basic strength na order kandidibekina. So base anta neevu tagondre, so adra strength na neevu consider madodadre, so the conjugate base of weak acid is strong. The conjugate base of strong acid is weak. So basic strength now consider madbeku antandre, we have to see the acidic strength of those compounds. Acidic strength. Iga alkane ide, alkene ide, alkynes ide. Ee alkane, alkene, alkynes ina acidic strength tagolodadre, we will write like this. Acidic strength of these alkanes, alkenes and alkynes are, so alkynes are more acidic than alkenes. Alkenes are more acidic than alkanes. So among alkane, alkene, alkyne, which is more acidic in nature? Alkynes. Why alkanes are more acidic in nature? Because here we have a carbon triple bond, carbon where the percentage of S character is more, and here this carbon is more electronegative, so that's why it accepts a pair of electron towards itself, and hydrogen will eliminate it very easily as H plus. So these alkynes are more acidic, strong acids among these. If you compare these three, alkynes are strong acids in nature. The base of this strong acid is weak. The conjugate base of this strong acid is weak. So if you take alkane, alkanes are least acidic in nature, because here in case of alkane, carbon single bond carbon will be there, percentage of S character is less, so electronegativity is also less, and these are less acidic weak acids. The conjugate base of weak acid is strong. The conjugate base of weak acid is strong. ಹಾಗಾಗಿ ಕಾರ್ಬನ್ ಅಯಾನ್ ಆಲ್ಕೇನ್ಸ್ ಇಂದ ಬಂದಿರುವಂತದಕ್ಕೆ ಬೇಸಿಕ್ ಸ್ಟ್ರೆಂತ್ ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ಇರುತ್ತೆ, ಅದೇ ಕಾರ್ಬನ್ ಅಯಾನು ಆಲ್ಕೈನ್ಸ್ ಇಂದ ಬಂದಿರುವಂತದಕ್ಕೆ ವೀಕ್ ಇರುತ್ತೆ ಬೇಸಿಕ್ ಸ್ಟ್ರೆಂತ್. ಯಾಕೆಂದ್ರೆ ಇದು ಸ್ಟ್ರಾಂಗ್ ಆಸಿಡ್ ಆಗಿರುತ್ತೆ, ಹಾಗಾಗಿ ಇದರ ಕಾಂಜುಗೇಟ್ ಬೇಸು ವೀಕ್ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ. ಇದು ವೀಕ್ ಆಸಿಡ್ ಆಗಿರುತ್ತೆ, ಇದರ ಕಾಂಜುಗೇಟ್ ಬೇಸು ಸ್ಟ್ರಾಂಗ್ ಆಗಿರುತ್ತೆ. ಸೊ ದಟ್ಸ್ ವೈ ಇಫ್ ಯು ಗೋ ಥ್ರೂ ವಿತ್ ದ ಆರ್ಡರ್, ಸೊ ಲೀಸ್ಟ್ ಬೇಸಿಕ್ ಸ್ಟ್ರೆಂತ್ ಇರುವಂತದ್ದು ಆಲ್ಕೈನ್ಸ್ ಇಂದ ಬಂದಿರುವಂಥದ್ದು, ಮೋರ್ ಬೇಸಿಕ್ ಸ್ಟ್ರೆಂತ್ ಇರುವಂಥದ್ದು ಆಲ್ಕೈನ್ಸ್ ಇಂದ ಬಂದಿರುವಂಥದ್ದು. ಸೊ ಹಾಗಾಗಿ ನಾವು ಆರ್ಡರ್ ತಗೊಂಡ್ರೆ 3-2-1 ಬರಿತೀವಿ. ಸೊ ಅಥವಾ ನೀವು ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಕೊಟ್ಟಿರುವಂತಹ ಆರ್ಡರ್ನ ಕಂಪೇರ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಹೋದ್ರೆ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಇರುವಂತದ್ರಲ್ಲಿ ಮೋರ್ ಅಸಿಡಿಕ್ ಇರೋದು, ಮೋರ್ ಬೇಸಿಕ್ ಸ್ಟ್ರೆಂತ್ ಇರುವಂಥದ್ದು ಆಲ್ಕೈನ್ಸ್ ಗೆ. ಹಾಗಾಗಿ ಆಪ್ಷನ್ ಬಿನ ರೈಟ್ ಆನ್ಸರ್ ಅಂತ ನಾವು ತಗೊಳ್ತೀವಿ. ಯಾಕೆ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ಈಸ್ ಮೋರ್ ಬೇಸಿಕ್ ದನ್ ದಿಸ್ ದನ್ ದಿಸ್. ಇದು ಆಲ್ಕೇನ್, ಇದು ಆಲ್ಕೀನ್, ಇದು ಆಲ್ಕೈನ್ಸ್. ಅಸಿಡಿಕ್ ಆರ್ಡರ್ ಇನ ಉಲ್ಟಾ ಬರ್ಬೇಕು ನೀವು ಬೇಸಿಕ್ ಆರ್ಡರ್ ನೋಡೋದು. ಓಕೆನಾ? ಸೊ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ತಗೊಂಡ್ರೆ ಎರಡನೇ ಕ್ವಶನ್, ದ ಯು ಪಿ ಎಸ್ ಸಿ ನೇಮ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಕಾಂಪೌಂಡ್ ಹ್ಯಾವಿಂಗ್ ಫಾರ್ಮುಲಾ ಅಂತೇಳಿ ಸಿ ಹೆಚ್ ಟ್ರಿಪಲ್ ಬಾಂಡ್ ಸಿ ಸಿ ಹೆಚ್ ಡಬಲ್ ಬಾಂಡ್ ಸಿ ಹೆಚ್ ಟು ಇದೆ. ಸೊ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ನೀವು ಕಾರ್ಬನ್ ಮೇನ್ ಚೈನ್ ನ ಕನ್ಸಿಡರ್ ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಳ್ಬೇಕಾಗುತ್ತೆ. ಸೊ ಕಾರ್ಬನ್ ಮೇನ್ ಚೈನ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ನೀವು ನಂಬರಿಂಗ್ ಮಾಡ್ಬೇಕಾಗುತ್ತೆ. ಸೊ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಡಬಲ್ ಮತ್ತೆ ಟ್ರಿಪಲ್ ಬಾಂಡ್ ಎಲ್ಲೂ ಇದೆ, ಎರಡೂ ಇರೋದ್ರಿಂದ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಗೋ ಥ್ರೂ ವಿತ್ ದ ಆಲ್ಫಾಬೆಟಿಕಲ್ ಆರ್ಡರ್. ಸೊ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಇನ್ ಆಮೇಲೆ ಐನ್, ಇನ್ಐನ್ ಅಂತ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ ಇದು. ಸೊ ಕಾರ್ಬನ್ ನಂಬರಿಂಗ್ ಇಲ್ಲಿಂದ ಕೊಟ್ರೆ 1-2-3-4 ಈ ತರ ಬರುತ್ತೆ. ಸೊ ಇದಕ್ಕೆ ನೀವು ನಾಮಿನ್ಕ್ಲೇಚರ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ರೆ ನೀವೇನಾಗುತ್ತೆ ಬ್ಯೂಟ್ ವರ್ಡ್ ರೂಟ್. ಸೊ ವರ್ಡ್ ರೂಟ್ ಏನು ಬ್ಯೂಟ್. ಸೊ ಸಫಿಕ್ಸ್ ಇಲ್ಲ, ಯಾಕಂದ್ರೆ ಯಾವ್ದು ಸಬ್ಸ್ಟಿಟ್ಯೂಯೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಇಲ್ಲ, ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಎರಡು ಪ್ರಿಫಿಕ್ಸ್ ಅಲ್ಲೇ ಬರಿಬೇಕಾಗುತ್ತೆ. ಸೊ ಬ್ಯೂಟ್ ಒನ್ ಇನ್ ತ್ರೀ ಐನ್. ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ಈಸ್ ದ ಕರೆಕ್ಟ್ ಐ ಯು ಪಿ ಎಸ್ ಸಿ ನೇಮ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿಸ್ ಗಿವೆನ್ ಆರ್ಗ್ಯಾನಿಕ್ ಕಾಂಪೌಂಡ್. ಅಂಡ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಗಿವೆನ್ ಆಪ್ಷನ್ಸ್ ದ ರೈಟ್ ಆನ್ಸರ್ ಇಯರ್ ಈಸ್ ಆಪ್ಷನ್. So next question is, which of the following species is not electrophilic in nature? So ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಕೊಟ್ಟಿರುವಂತಹ ಆಪ್ಷನ್ಸ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಯಾವ್ದು ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರೋಫೈಲೇ ಅಲ್ಲ ಅಂತ ನೀವು ನೋಡ್ಬೇಕಾಗುತ್ತೆ. ಸೊ ಜನರಲಿ ಪಾಸಿಟಿವ್ ಚಾರ್ಜ್ ಇರುವಂತವೆಲ್ಲ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರೋಫೈಲ್ಸ್. ಸೊ ಇದು ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರೋಫೈಲೇ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ, ಇದು ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರೋಫೈಲ್ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ, ಇದು ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರೋಫೈಲೇ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ. ಸೊ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಇನ್ನೊಂದು ಸ್ಪೀಶೀಸ್ ಇದೆ BH3 ಅಂತೇಳಿ, ಇದನ್ನ ನಾವು ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರೋಫೈಲ್ ಅಂತ ಕರಿಬೋದ ಕರೆಯಂಗಿಲ್ಲ ನೋಡ್ಬೇಕೀಗ. ಸೊ generally these three can act as a electrophile in nature. So but this BH3 does not contain any positive charge, so that's why this option B is the right answer here. Next question is, which of the following compound will exhibit cis trans geometrical isomerism? I told you already, so one of the ಸ್ಟೀರಿಯೋಐಸೋಮೆರಿಸಮ್ ಈಸ್ ಜಿಯೋಮೆಟ್ರಿಕಲ್ ಐಸೋಮೆರಿಸಮ್. ಸೊ ಜಿಯೋಮೆಟ್ರಿಕಲ್ ಐಸೋಮೆರಿಸಮ್ಸ್ ತೋರಿಸ್ಬೇಕು ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಕಂಪಲ್ಸರಿ ಕಾರ್ಬನ್ ಕಾರ್ಬನ್ ಡಬಲ್ ಬಾಂಡ್ ಇರಬೇಕು, ಅಂಡ್ ಈ ಡಬಲ್ ಬಾಂಡ್ ಅಟ್ಯಾಚ್ ಆಗಿರುವಂತಹ ಗ್ರೂಪ್ಸ್ ಡಿಫ್ರೆಂಟ್ ಇರ್ಬೇಕು. ಈ ರೀತಿ ಡಿಫ್ರೆಂಟ್ ಗ್ರೂಪ್ ಶುಡ್ ಬಿ ಅಟ್ಯಾಚ್ ಟು ಡಬಲ್ ಬಾಂಡ್ ಕಾರ್ಬನ್ ಐಟಮ್ಸ್. ಈ ರೀತಿ ಇರುವಂತಹ ಕಾಂಪೌಂಡ್ ಜಿಯೋಮೆಟ್ರಿಕಲ್ ಐಸೋಮೆರಿಸಮ್ ನ ತೋರಿಸುತ್ತೆ. ಕೊಟ್ಟಿರುವಂತಹ ಆಪ್ಷನ್ಸ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಬ್ಯೂಟ್ 2-ಇನ್ ತಗೊಳ್ಳಿ. ಬ್ಯೂಟ್ 2-ಇನ್ ಫಾರ್ಮುಲಾ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಸೊ CH3CH ಡಬಲ್ ಬಾಂಡ್ CH CH3. ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ವಾಟ್ ಬ್ಯೂಟ್ 2-ಇನ್. ಸೊ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಡಬಲ್ ಬಾಂಡೆಡ್ ಕಾರ್ಬನ್ ಐಟಮ್ಸ್ ಇದೆ, ಆ ಡಬಲ್ ಬಾಂಡೆಡ್ ಕಾರ್ಬನ್ ಐಟಮ್ಸ್ ಕೂಡ ಡಿಫ್ರೆಂಟ್ ಗ್ರೂಪ್ಸ್ ಗೆ ಅಟ್ಯಾಚ್ ಆಗಿದೆ. ಸೊ ಇಫ್ ಯು ಟೇಕ್ ದಿಸ್ ಕಾರ್ಬನ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಬಾಂಡೆಡ್ ವಿತ್ ಒನ್ ಹೈಡ್ರೋಜನ್ ಒನ್ CH3 ಗ್ರೂಪ್. ಸೊ ಇಫ್ ಯು ಟೇಕ್ ದಿಸ್ ಕಾರ್ಬನ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಬಾಂಡೆಡ್ ವಿತ್ ಒನ್ ಹೈಡ್ರೋಜನ್ ಒನ್ CH3. ಸೊ ಇಫ್ ಯು ಪಾಸ್ ಎ ಪ್ಲೇನ್ ಆಫ್ ಸಿಮಿಟ್ರಿ ಇಯರ್, ಸೊ ಡಬಲ್ ಬಾಂಡ್ ಅಪೋ ನೋಡಿ ಅಪ್ಪರ್ ಸೈಡ್ ಆಗ ತಗೊಳ್ಳಿ ಲೋಯರ್ ಸೈಡ್ ಆಗ ತಗೊಳ್ಳಿ ಸಿಮಿಲರ್ ಗ್ರೂಪ್ಸ್ ಇರೋದ್ರಿಂದ ಇದನ್ನ ಸಿಸ್ ಐಸೋಮರ್ ಅಂತ ಕರಿತೀವಿ. ಸೊ ನೀವು ಸಿ ಡಬಲ್ ಬಾಂಡ್ ಸಿ ತಗೊಳ್ಳಿ, ಸೊ ಹೈಡ್ರೋಜನ್ CH3 ಹಿಂಗೆ ಇದೆ. ಸೊ ಈ ಕಡೆ ಕಾರ್ಬನಿನ ಹೈಡ್ರೋಜನ್ ನ ಕೆಳಗೆ ಬರೀರಿ, CH3 ನ ಮೇಲ್ ಬರೆದ್ರೆ ಸೊ ಸಿಮಿಲರ್ ಗ್ರೂಪ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಅಟ್ಯಾಚ್ ಟು ದ ಆಪೋಸಿಟ್ ಸೈಡ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಡಬಲ್ ಬಾಂಡ್, ಅಂಡ್ ದಿಸ್ ಈಸ್ ವಾಟ್ ವಿ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಆಸ್ ಅ ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸ್ ಐಸೋಮರ್. ಸೊ ದಟ್ಸ್ ವೈ ಬ್ಯೂಟ್ 2-ಇನ್ ಆರ್ 2-ಬ್ಯೂಟೀನ್ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಶೋ ಸೊ ಜಿಯೋಮೆಟ್ರಿಕಲ್ ಐಸೋಮೆರಿಸಮ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಗಿವನ್ ಆಪ್ಷನ್. ಎನ್ಸ್ ಆಪ್ಷನ್ ಡಿ ಇಸ್ ದ ರೈಟ್ ಆನ್ಸರ್. ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಕ್ವಶನ್ ಈಸ್, ಅಮಾಂಗ್ ದ ಫಾಲೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಕಾಂಪೌಂಡ್ಸ್ ದ ಒನ್ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಮೋಸ್ಟ್ ರಿಯಾಕ್ಟಿವ್ ಟುವರ್ಡ್ಸ್ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರೋಫಿಲಿಕ್ ನೈಟ್ರೇಷನ್. ಸೊ ವಿ ನೋ ದಟ್ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರೋಫಿಲಿಕ್ ಸಬ್ಸ್ಟಿಟ್ಯೂಷನ್ ರಿಯಾಕ್ಷನ್ಸ್, So there are 5 electrophilic substitution reactions are there for benzene, that is halogenation, nitration, sulfonation, and Friedel-Crafts alkylation and Friedel-Crafts acylation. So here he given, so benzoic acid is the first option. In case of benzoic acid, an electron withdrawing carboxyl group is attached to benzene, which is a ring deactivating group. Hence, it also does not favors towards electrophilic nitration because of deactivating electron withdrawing group present here. As the electron withdrawing group increases, what happens to the benzene? So it withdraws electrons from the benzene. As a result, electron density of the benzene decreases. Benzene ali electron density kadimi adre, negative charges, electrons in a sankhya kadimi adre. So idu next baruvanta electrophile na attack maduvanta capacity kadimi maadkolutte. So na en helta idinandre, ring activating groups ellidiyo alli reactivity towards electrophilic substitution reaction increase agutte. Ring deactivating group, electron withdrawing groups ellalli irutho allella reactivity towards electrophilic substitution reaction decrease agutte. So benzoic acid alli deactivating group ide, nitrobenzene allu kuda electron withdrawing group irodrinda deactivating group ide, but toluene alli benzene mele CH3 group ide, which is electron donating group. This donating group irodrinda, so this is more reactive towards electrophilic nitration. So illi benzene, normal benzene ide, so idikke yavudu effect e illa, okay na. So ee naalku options ni consider maadkondre elli nimge ringina mele activating group irodu toluene alli, hage toluene is more reactive towards electrophilic nitration, hence option C is the right answer. So next question is, the most stable carbanion, I told you carbon carrying negative charge is called carbanion. Among the following is, I told you the order also, primary carbanion is more stable than secondary is more stable than tertiary. This primary is more stable and simple means carbon carrying only hydrogens, okay na. So illi ni nodudre idu primary barthe, so idu tertiary barthe, idu secondary barthe, idu simple carbanion barthe. So hagagi kottiruvanta naalku options alli more stable carbon ion yavudu, so simple carbon ion, hence option A is the right answer. Next question is, the correct order of stability of carbocation is, carbocationina order of stability na already helidini, benzyl carbocation is more stable than tertiary is more stable than secondary is more stable than primary. So hagagi kottiruvanta options alli, so benzyl is more stable than tertiary, then primary, hagagi option B is the right answer. So next, if 0.32 gram of an organic compound containing sulfur produces 0.233 gram of barium sulfate, so then the percentage of sulfur in it is, so this is one of the question regarding quantitative analysis. So we are going to find the percentage of sulfur. So percentage of sulfur can be identified, so percentage of any element is calculated by using formula, percentage of any element in organic compound in the quantitative analysis calculated using formula, atomic weight of that element into x is nothing but number of atoms, so divided by molecular weight of compound obtained, compound not organic compound. So now yavade ondu element na innondu form ge convert maadirthivalva adra molecular weight into weight of that compound, bandiruvanta compound ina weight divided by weight of organic compound into 100. So this is the general formula to calculate percentage of any element in the given organic compound. So atomic weight ide, a element ina atomic weight akoli, x ide number andre 1 idre 1, 2 idre formula dali estidiyo adu, divided by molecular weight of the compound obtained. So ನೀನು ಕಾರ್ಬನ್ ನ ಕಾರ್ಬನ್ ಡೈಆಕ್ಸೈಡ್ ಕನ್ವರ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಳ್ತೀಯ, ಹಾಗಾಗಿ ಮಾಲಿಕ್ಯುಲರ್ ವೈಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಕಾರ್ಬನ್ ಡೈಆಕ್ಸೈಡ್ ತಗೊಳ್ಬೇಕಾಗುತ್ತೆ. ಹೈಡ್ರೋಜನ್ ಇದ್ರೆ ವಾಟರ್ ಕನ್ವರ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಳ್ತೀಯ, ಸಲ್ಫರ್ ಇದ್ರೆ ಬೇರಿಯಂ ಸಲ್ಫೇಟ್ ಕನ್ವರ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಳ್ತೀಯ, ಫಾಸ್ಫರಸ್ ಇದ್ರೆ ಅಮೋನಿಯಂ ಫಾಸ್ಫೋಮಾಲಿಬ್ರೇಟ್ ಗೆ ಕನ್ವರ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಳ್ತೀಯ, ಹ್ಯಾಲೋಜನ್ ಇದ್ರೆ AgX ಫಾರ್ಮ್ ಗೆ ಕನ್ವರ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಳ್ತೀಯ. ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಸೊ ನೀವು ಎಲಿಮೆಂಟ್ ನ ಯಾವ ಫಾರ್ಮ್ ಗೆ ಕನ್ವರ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಂಡಿರ್ತೀಯೋ ಆ ಫಾರ್ಮಿನ ಮಾಲಿಕ್ಯುಲಾರ್ ವೈಟ್ ತಗೊಳ್ಬೇಕು ಇಂಟು ವೈಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಎಸ್ ಕಾಂಪೌಂಡ್ ವೈಟ್, ವೈಟ್ ಎಷ್ಟು ಬಂದಿದೆ, ಎಸ್ ಗ್ರಾಮ್ಸ್ ಬಂದಿದೆ, ಅದು ಡಿವೈಡೆಡ್ ಬೈ ವೈಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಆರ್ಗ್ಯಾನಿಕ್ ಕಾಂಪೌಂಡ್ ಇಂಟು 100. ಸೊ ಈಗ ನಾವು ಈ ಫಾರ್ಮುಲಾನ ಸಬ್ಸ್ಟಿಟ್ಯೂಷನ್ ಮಾಡೋದಾದ್ರೆ ಪರ್ಸೆಂಟೇಜ್ ಆಫ್ ಸಲ್ಫರ್ ನ ಕಂಡುಹಿಡಿಬೇಕು. ಸೊ ಹಾಗಾಗಿ ನಾವು ಬೇರಿಯಂ ಸಲ್ಫೇಟ್ ಗೆ ಕನ್ವರ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಂಡಿದೀವಿ. ಈ ಫಾರ್ಮುಲಾದಲ್ಲಿ ಒಂದು ಸಲ್ಫರ್ ಆಟಮ್ ಇರೋದ್ರಿಂದ ಎಕ್ಸ್ ಇನ ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂ 1 ಆಗುತ್ತೆ, ಅಟೋಮಿಕ್ ವೈಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಸಲ್ಫರ್ 32 ಆಗುತ್ತೆ, ಡಿವೈಡೆಡ್ ಬೈ ಮಾಲಿಕ್ಯುಲಾರ್ ವೈಟ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಕಾಂಪೌಂಡ್ ಒಬ್ ಟೈಮ್ ಬೇರಿಯಂ ಸಲ್ಫೇಟ್ ನ ಮಾಲಿಕ್ಯುಲಾರ್ ವೈಟ್ ತಗೊಳ್ಳೋದಾದ್ರೆ 233 ಇಂಟು ಸೊ ವೈಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಕಾಂಪೌಂಡ್ ಒಕ್ ಟೈಮ್ ಎಷ್ಟು ಗ್ರಾಮ್ ಎಷ್ಟು ವೈಟ್ ಕಾಂಪೌಂಡ್ ಬಂದಿದೆ ಅದು. ಸೊ 0.32 ಗ್ರಾಮ್ ಆಫ್ ಆರ್ಗ್ಯಾನಿಕ್ ಕಾಂಪೌಂಡ್ ಕಂಟೈನಿಂಗ್ ಸಲ್ಫರ್ ಪ್ರೊಡ್ಯೂಸರ್ಸ್ 0.233 ಗ್ರಾಮ್ ಆಫ್ ಬೇರಿಯಂ ಸಲ್ಫೇಟ್. ಎಷ್ಟು ವೈಟ್ ಬಂದಿದೆ ಇದು 0.233 ಡಿವೈಡೆಡ್ ಬೈ ಸೊ ಯಾವುದು 0.32 ವೈಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಆರ್ಗ್ಯಾನಿಕ್ ಕಾಂಪೌಂಡ್ ಇಂಟು 100. ಸೊ ಇದಿಷ್ಟನ್ನು ನೀವು ಮಾಡಿದ್ರೆ ಸೊ ಇದನ್ನ ನೀವು ಕ್ಯಾಲ್ಕುಲೇಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಂಡ್ರೆ ಸೊ ಇಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಗಿವಿಂಗ್ 10% ಆಫ್ ಸಲ್ಫರ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಒಬ್ಟೈನ್ಡ್ ಹೆನ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಗಿವನ್ ಆಪ್ಷನ್. ಸೊ ಹಿಯರ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ 10 ಇಸ್ ದೇರ್, ಹೆನ್ಸ್ ಆಪ್ಷನ್ A ಇಸ್ ದ ರೈಟ್ ಆನ್ಸರ್.